There are hundreds of proof-of-stake networks, and the staking industry in total is currently growing between 50 to 100 million US dollar in staking market cap every single day. Pulling together key metrics from multiple platforms is challenging and often totally overwhelming. So we designed our new asset table to bring you all staking data in one easy-to-compare format. Let's take a dive into the 7 new features of the asset table. And stay with us until the end, as all 7 points here mentioned are important and reinforce each other. You will be surprised how much alpha you can get out of good, easy to compare staking data alone. The first key feature of our new asset table is obviously the type selection, so you can see metrics by different types. First of all, we have proof of stake category and all the other ecosystems combined here. So if you want to see tokens from only the Ethereum ecosystem, you can select Ethereum and then see all the stakeable tokens within the Ethereum ecosystem. There are 28 currently, and if you go to proof of stake, you scroll down, you see there are way more here. We have 70 stakeable tokens in general. So that's the first interesting feature here, comparing tokens by ecosystem, by type, either from the ecosystem or from proof of stake directly. The second amazing feature here is that you see 18 staking metrics for each chain in a comparable format. So starting with the staking market cap, and we've grouped them into risk, reward, and momentum metrics. So this is something, if you want to dive into any of these metrics from any of the chains that are listed here, over 100 in the total asset table, check out the expanded view. Third one, you can actually sort by these metrics, and the sorted ones are always highlighted in yellow here. So for example, you want to sort by net staking flow 24 hours. So you select this here and you see the tokens sorted by net staking flow in the last 24 hours here, and can explore which of them compare highest. You can change the sorting by descending and ascending, and there are over 14 metrics to sort here. The ROI, DALU volume, staking wallets is very interesting. And for the ones that are within the expanded view, if you sort by them, they automatically move to the front here. So you can see them directly in a comparable format highlighted in yellow. The third use case is you can actually see the change percentages and change absolutes over time. We have from 24 hours to 1 year timeframes. And if you select these, it changes across all metrics. So you always see the change percentage in staking market cap, stake tokens, reward rate, rewards per year, and so on, always in the selected timeframe here. So you can actually make good comparisons how these tokens perform against each other and how they stack up in terms of the changes over the last either 24 hours, 7 days, 30 days, 90 days, or even 1 year. Fifth use case is you see the net staking flow. This is a new metric we've introduced, and it's a very interesting one. You see it here as the mini chart on the right, and then in an expanded version here for the last 7 days. So you can see exactly how did the stake tokens at current prices change over the last 7 days in a chart format. And you can see Ethereum has like a very positive staking, like net staking inflow. So that's the outflow like subtracted by the inflow. And then we have a net positive here, whereas in Cardano, you can see only yesterday it has been positive. Apart from that, there has been a net outflow in terms of the total stake tokens at current prices. And in a comparable format, you also see the net staking flow 24 hours here as a standalone metric for the last point in the chart here. The sixth very interesting metric that I would like to highlight is the stake tokens trend 24 hours. So this is comparing the last 24 hours stake tokens change compared to the 30-day average. So this is really interesting to see if there is a certain token really like standing out in terms of the most recent staking activity. You can sort by it here and compare, and then you see like, wow, like in the last 24 hours, TomoChain, Tezos, Edgeware, they all had like over 1000% in the change from the last 24 hours net staking inflow compared to the 30-day average. And last but not least, I would like to highlight the seventh feature, and this is an amazing one. You see the ROI of the last 365 days broken down into price ROI and staking ROI. So this is a great feature. For example, if a certain token went down in price, but the API from staking was very high. So it could have gone up actually if you held it and staked it. So you can see the actual difference here. And you can see here, for example, the total ROI from TomoChain in the last 365 days has been plus 131%. Whereas from price only, it was only 107%. So there's a big difference. And for some tokens, this is even a much stronger significant point where the staking always offsets the either price gains or these like boosts the price gains, or it like offsets the price losses. And especially for like very high APY tokens, this makes a huge difference. So I highly encourage you to check this out. Go to our current new asset table, check out these metrics, compare the different tokens to each other. Let us know your feedback. We are very keen to improving on the metrics and on the table itself. We want to make it as valuable for you as possible. So please let us know any comment, any features you would like to see, any data points. So we will make sure to include them in the next version of our asset table. Until then, stay with us and happy staking.